Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today we are going to make this animation in PowerPoint 2016. I have seen this GIF file on reddit.com and thought why not we should try this on PowerPoint. And as you can see that there are 13 dots moving around and at one time they all get together and create a very nice animation here, whereas in my animation I have taken only 8 dots, whereas there are 13 dots here. And you can add as many dots as you want, and as you can see that the dots are moving on top of each shape. So that is what we have to learn, that how we can create this effect. And let's get started. And for that I will take a new presentation by clicking on the file menu, then clicking on new, and then clicking on blank presentation. Then I will collapse the thumbnail view, and then we'll change the layout from the layer drop down button and choosing the blank. Okay, so first of all I insert the, actually this tutorial is all about using the custom motion paths. And let me tell you one thing first, that first of all I insert a shape and I choose a triangle and draw it here, and then I choose no fill from the shape fill drop down button, and then change the outline color to black, and then I draw a oval. I take an oval here and click inside the presentation, and it will create a default 1x1 size oval here. And hold down the Ctrl, Alt and Shift keys, and then hold down the oval and then reduce the size. Holding the Ctrl, Alt and Shift keys and then reducing the size will reduce the size simultaneously from all the sides. Now I will place the dot right here. Okay, now I want to apply the motion path. I want this dot to move over the triangle, and for that I go to the animation tab, click on the add animation drop down button and go to more motion paths, and here I choose triangle equal triangle motion path, hit the OK button, and as you can see that it has drawn the triangle motion path below our triangle. So I have to adjust the path here, and if I move the path, as you can see, if I adjust the path here, as you can see that our actual oval position is right here, whereas the motion path is starting from right here. If I show you the preview, it will start moving from right here. And that is what I don't want. So actually if you want to apply the path according to the shapes, that is not quite possible in PowerPoint. Even if you, here is another option here, let me show you that. If you want to move that motion path anywhere on the screen, as you can see that I am moving the motion path, but the actual object is on the same position. So what I can do here, I can go to the effect options and then I can click on locked. And if now I will change the motion path and then I change the oval position, the motion path and the object will remain on the same position. Whereas if I don't choose the locked, instead of choosing the locked origin, instead if I choose the unlocked origin, which is the default option, and if and then I try to move the motion path, and later if I adjust the actual object position, sorry, then it will also change the motion path position. So to avoid that, we choose the locked origin. And if now I move the object, the motion path and the original object will remain on the same position, and that will create the animation. But that procedure cannot be used to create this animation, and I tell you why. Now we take the second shape, and that is a rectangle, and I draw it over here and choose no fill and change the outline color. Now I will draw an oval here, and then we'll reduce the size by holding Ctrl Alt and Shift keys, and I want to place it right here. And now if I go to the animation tab and apply a rectangle motion path to this object, see what will happen here. Okay, let me adjust the path. Okay, so that is what the problem with the PowerPoint. You can't adjust the starting point of the motion path. So as you can see that our original object is right here, and I want this object to be right here, but the actual starting point of the motion path is right here, and you can't change that in PowerPoint. And that is what the problem is when you need to create this kind of animation in PowerPoint. You can't adjust the starting points of the motion path. So what you can do here is, I will delete that and we'll start from the beginning. See, there are a lot of shapes here, and when you will draw the shape and then will draw the motion paths over the shape, then you can't adjust the starting point. Maybe one dot will start from here, one dot will start from here, or another dot will start from right here. So you can't adjust the starting points of the motion path in PowerPoint 2016. And I think Microsoft should take care of that in the next version of the PowerPoint. So how you can animate the objects? Let me draw another shape here. And to resolve this, what I will do, if I want all the objects to start right from here instead of right from here, so what I can do here, I will use the custom motion path instead. And for that I go to add animation, more motion path, and if you see here, you will never find custom motion path in this list. And to use the custom motion path, you always have to use animation. In the animation tab, you always have to use this drop down button and use the custom path from here. And now you can draw the custom path as you like, and using the custom path you can define that what should be the starting point. Like, I want the starting point to be right here, so I will click first right here, then we'll take the mouse over here, then click once again, then here, then here, and then I will close the path. That way you also don't have to adjust the position of the motion path, and that will save a lot of time of yours. Now I draw the next shape, that is a rectangle like this. Choose no fill, and I copy the same oval here, copy, paste, and open the animation pane, and you can see that it has also copied the same animation effect to the rectangle. So I will delete it, select the animation and hit the delete key from the keyboard, and I want this dot right here. And I want the starting point of this dot to be right here on the same position as the above. And so for that I will again use the custom paths, and will start drawing the path from this position like this, then over here, then over here, then here, and then close the path. Oh, I did it wrong. And for that, I select the oval, go to the animation tab, hit the drop down button and choose custom path and start drawing the path from right here. Then click here, then here. That way you can choose the right starting point for your animation. If you choose the ready-made custom motion path, then you are not able to choose what should be the starting point. So that is why I am using the custom motion path. Let me show you the preview. And both are working fine. And that is what I have did in this animation. Let me show you that by opening the animation pane. Let me delete this one. Okay, let me change the background so you can see everything clearly. Okay, and as you can see that I have drawn all the shapes, and these shapes are available in the shapes drop down button. As you can see here, we have 8-point star, 10-point star, 12-point stars, or you can use the freeform tool to draw the shapes by yourself. Here you have 7 heptagon, 7 corner heptagon, 8 corners and so on. And I did this, I have drawn all the shapes using the shapes drop down button. And as you can see, I have drawn custom motion path for each object. As you can see here, that was the only thing to learn in this tutorial, that how you can use custom motion path to draw a specific path for your animation. And later you can select all the animations by selecting the first one, then holding the shift key from the keyboard, and then selecting the last one. And you have to set all the animation to start with previous, and then you can define the timings. And timings are a bit important in this animation, as you can see that the first oval will move around for around half a second, and the rectangle animation will take around 1 second, and then the next animation will take 1.5 second. As you can see that these animations are adjoining at certain points. As you can see that at this point, these 5 dots will be on the same position, and at this point all the dots will be at the same position, and that will be the 12 seconds. Let me show you the preview. As you can see that all are moving, and this last dot will take around 12 seconds to complete the circle, and at 12 seconds all the dots will be at the same position. So that was the only thing to learn in this animation, that how you can use custom path to assign a starting point for your motion paths. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving a comment or by liking this video, and you can also share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching and take care.